Miramar is one of six municipalities where every school is actually covered by an SRO. So they have a really strong commitment there. I think it's a model for the entire county. So we do have a mechanism and a structure in place by which to provide security services to our schools. There's a bill, legislation, the School Safety Act of Broward County, that's been proposed by Senator Sobe. Again, we join her in sharing the same passion and commitment to ensure that our schools are safe. We do have a couple concerns with this bill. One is that it creates a separate governing structure. Again, I believe that we already have a mechanism to do that. I think the city of Miramar, for example, is a fine example of how that can be accomplished, rather than creating a separate entity and bureaucracy for taxpayers. Secondly, this bill requires a referendum in 2014. When you look at the time frame associated with this, we're looking at about 3 years before we would see any resources. And I know this board and I have been pretty clear that we're not going to wait 3 years. We need to do things now, and we have been working on some of the things that we've identified.
I was brought up really to not look a gift horse in the mouth, and basically there's no plan right now to bring money into Broward County. And this is a plan that, yes, wouldn't bring any money in and for two more years, but it's a plan to bring money in for two more years. Is it perfect? By all means, no.
I, as one board member, will not go to the taxpayers before I know that we have exhausted every resource in being able to provide what we need to provide for our district, and then ask them for additional dollars if we needed them. At this point, I don't hear our superintendent saying that this is a resource he needs in order to keep our children safe in schools. Therefore, it's certainly not something that I, as a board member, would support.
Second, Mr. Runcie went and explained our position, and from speaking to people who were in the audience, he was treated very rudely and was told that we don't provide safety and that we're not doing what's best for kids. So I have a real issue with that, my superintendent being treated that way at a delegation meeting. Next, you're the governing board. You're elected to take care of school safety. Basically now, the SROs, the interlocal agreements, interagency agreements we have with the SROs, mental health services that could be provided from the Office of Prevention, all of those things are going to be taken out of our hands. Our Office of Prevention has been killing themselves with the judge, with the Advancement Project, with the NAACP, to get a Clayton County agreement in place to help our students. You know what? We're not even going to be the entity that reaches in, if this passes, that's going to be able to sign that agreement, because everything has been taken out of our hands.
What's happened in the past with regards to our safety, where maybe, you know, this stimulated the need for this bill, I don't really find that, and I do believe that the superintendent has put the safety and security of our children first. Mm-hmm. And with that being said, that with having the proper resources, I'm confident that he's going to put forth everything that we're going to need, and I'm in support of your letter as a result.
Yes, we're ready to accept more money anytime anybody's willing to give us, but I'm not willing to give up any authority to anyone. The complexity in the operation of the school board, most people in Broward County don't even understand what our roles and responsibilities are, and that we are a separate governing body from Broward County commissioners and everything else. They don't even, when you talk to them, they think that we're under that umbrella. So again, you know, there's mixed signals going on out here, and I certainly would not accept anybody coming in as a Monday morning quarterback and telling me how to run the school system because of the complexity and what we already have in operations and the procedures that we have made to secure our schools.
We had an intense workshop yesterday on our district educational facilities plan. We're talking about a minor amount of money for this versus a major amount of money that we need to renovate our schools, for technology in our schools, and, you know, if we're going to go for a referendum, That's the kind of referendum you go to the voters for, to ask the voters to consider supporting.